Spectralayers Pro 7 by Steinberg is an audio editor with which you can edit, process and draw EQ on your audio with a spectral editor. In this video, I'll review the most recent version and show you how it can help you in mixing and mastering. Hi, I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. Working with an editor like Spectralayers requires a different approach than working with normal EQ plugins. Basically, it's a tool to process your audio. But instead of using dials and sliders, you draw directly onto your waveform. I have been using Spectralayers in every mastering I did for the last few years. And I also use it for fixing audio as a preparation for mixing and post-production. So what is to like about Spectralayers? First of all, it's the workflow. The visual display makes it very clear where the peaks and dips in the entire spectrum are. Darker colors represent frequencies which are lower in volume, and the brighter colors are frequencies which are louder. You can customize how you want to see the spectrum, in one color or composite, with all sorts of choices, in 2D or 3D, and how much of the spectrum you want to see, and so on. You can work inside Spectralayers like it is Photoshop. Key commands like zooming in and zooming out feel very familiar, and you have a whole range of selection tools like rectangular selection, magic wand and frequency selection, which all feel like you're in Photoshop. For all selection tools, you can set the range and things like the frequency fade, so how your adjustment fades into the unprocessed audio. Looks a lot like feathering in Photoshop. When you select an area, it will solo that frequency area to pinpoint the frequency. Let's do this low end and zoom in and adjust the frequency area we're looking at. You can do all sorts of processing on it in the process menu. For a large area like this, maybe I want to lower it with a few decibels by lowering the gain. You do it like this. Or if you want to do more gain reduction or boosting, you have tools like Booster or Eraser to pinpoint small parts and draw more gain reductions. You have audio fix tools like Clone Stamp and Frequency Repair, which are all helpful to optimize audio and fix issues. Let's check some more processing tools and work on some post-audio recording in Cubase with Spectralayers 7 as an Era 2 extension. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video on this channel, the channel to help you out in recording, mixing and mastering. It's quite roomy and has some resonances and noise, and such an important message should sound good. First, denoising. Select a region with noise and select Register Noise. Then choose Noise Reduction. Preview. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any. And apply. Please remember to subscribe. A lot of noise is already gone. What is nice is that you can select a noise region and apply that in two different steps. This works nicer than in a lot of other noise reduction plugins. Next up is reverb reduction. Press Analyze and set the threshold pretty high to start with. Preview. Subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any tweak. Subscribe to this channel and hit that notification. Subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video on this channel. And process. Subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video on this channel, the channel to help you. The reverb has been reduced. And also let's add some de-essing. Previewing. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell. Tweak. So you won't miss out on any new video on this channel, the channel to help you out in recording, mixing and process. There's some resonance happening and I'll remove that with the eraser. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you reduce by a few dBs Please remember to subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video on this channel. On this channel, the channel to help you out in recording, mixing, and mastering.
And done. So it went from this.
Subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video on this channel. The channel
to this.
Subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video on this channel. The channel to help.
And now this audio is well prepped to be mixed. In the standalone version, you can import multiple tracks and layer them. The frequency display shows us some of all layers, so you can easily pinpoint where problem areas are, so you can fix them in each layer. A word of caution, mixing is done with your ears and not with your eyes. So even when Spectra Layers is all about seeing what your audio does, you have to listen if the changes you make are the right ones. A bright peak does not have to mean it's too loud. Listen and adjust. Or don't. You can also get really creative with Spectra Layers. It's not all about fixing and EQing. For instance, you can also do time stretch and pitch shifting if you want. Just select a region and use the Transform tool to stretch and pitch shift. You can also paste this in over an existing audio part and get creative like that. Or select a region and do cut special to layer below and time stretch that a lot, so it gets into soundscape and drone creating. I'll demonstrate the next function inside Cubase with Spectra Layer 7 as an Era 2 extension. That is unmixing. This will isolate certain elements of a mix and put them in its own layer. For instance, if you choose Unmix Stems, you get this pop-up and you can select from these predetermined stems which ones you want. Let's do them all, and after Spectra Layers is done with its calculations, the mix gets split into multiple stems over here. Or, and here is what makes Spectra Layers so powerful, you can do something like the following. You duplicate the original track. Then you enable Spectra Layers on it. And do the stem unmix. You delete all tracks except the vocal. Then you select Merge and, at least that is what I do, commit to having only the vocal by bouncing the track. Now you're left with just the vocal and it has some artifacts as you can hear. So I add an EQ to remove some of those and insert something like a delay. The delay is set to 100% wet since I only want the effect. So this enables you to add effects to existing mixes, and this is not even that far-fetched. I had to do this more than once. Can you add some more reverb to the vocal in a master? This makes it very easy to do. A few other things you could do is inverse the phase on the extracted vocal and blend it in with the original track to reduce the volume of the vocal in the mix. or completely slam the vocal with compression, and blend it in slightly when you feel the vocal needs more presence. And of course, this will work with the other extracted stems too. The other option is to extract components like tone, noise, and transient. I did that already on this track, and let's use the noise layer and blend that in with phase reversed. As you can hear, the original song will get cleaner like this. And when I blend the drums back in a bit, the balance is pretty much changed. This is a way to add more development to a master. And by muting the vocal in the layers, you can easily create instrumentals for karaoke. And muting the drums will give you an easy way to blend in new drums for instance, YouTube drum covers. Spectra Layer 7 is a powerful package to EQ into detail, do audio prepping, fixing audio, do post-processing and do more of the functions I mentioned in the video like the audio unmix. At first sight, it may not be as quick as using a few plugins on a track, but you save time by not having to go through every track doing automation checks. Because with Spectra Layers, you process right on the spot where it's needed. I use Spectra Layers inside Cubase since the day it was released as an Era 2 compatible extension. It sped up my workflow for mastering and audio preparation, and it can work more in detail more easily. Needless to say, I can really recommend Spectra Layer 7, especially when you have an Era 2 compatible DAW like Cubase 10.5. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!